All right, Hearties, it's day three. Day three in Vancouver. What a day it was. What an incredibly crazy, amazing, fulfilling day it was. How do I even begin? Here in Vancouver, Canada, at the Glen Calls the Heart Hearties Family Reunion. Oh my goodness, today was awesome. I don't even know where to begin. At the beginning of the day, met up with James Lott Jr. Took a cab over to the Sheraton Hotel. Today is the day of the star interviews. We had Erin Krakow, Daniel Lissing, Lori Laughlin, Pascal Hutton, and Paul Green. We have five people. We get to the hotel, we get our Starbucks, we dump everything off at the green room. Sorry, my brain is fried. If you hear this loud buzzing, that's because I'm literally sending my laptop RAM overload because I'm literally rendering all the interviews that we did today, so my computer's working on overdrive right now. That's the explanation for the loud noise if you hear. We go into the big conference room where everyone is. All the Hearties. It was early in the morning, but I can't even tell you like how long those Hearties were waiting. James and I just, you know, popped right in. Saw the Brian Bird, of course. Production cast comes in. They did the Q&A panels. Really cool listening to them, especially coming from a person who's on the production side of media. I have a true and deep respect and understanding for these guys who work day in, day out, hours and hours and hours of work that they did, people see, but people don't see the people behind the scene. And they are the true unsung heroes of production, of movies, of television, of just production in general. They are the unsung heroes who don't get enough credit. They are thankless jobs. Trust me, they are thankless jobs. So, from one producer in this industry to all the other people who work hard every single day to make a product great, I applaud them. Great insight. And John Cerita was there, the composer. I love the music for Ren Calls the Heart. I love instrumental music. I think it's fantastic. My Pandora is like all instrumental music. I saw a lot of cool people there. People in VFX, people in wardrobe, AD people, or like the first AD person, the directors, you know, all the people that help get Ren Calls the Heart internationally syndicated, you know, on Netflix and stuff like those things you don't think of. People are the ones behind and making it happen. A deep appreciation for the production people in all shapes and forms and aspect of this show. So we did that, and maybe a few minutes later, it might have been like 10 minutes later, we had the cast. Group A, we had the cast Q&A panel. We had Lori, Carter, Erin, Daniel, Pascal, Kevin, Jack Wagner. I'm going through my mind. I think that was it. Main panel. Missing it a minute. I feel bad. But I'm going off of memory here. Literally. Another Q&A session with them. It was fun. You can definitely tell this cast gets along so well. And in a production environment, that means that can make or break a show. That really can. And I think that's what makes the show work so much. It's because they love each other, because they genuinely enjoy each other's presence, they still keep working. The show still goes on. I just wish all places were like that, all productions are like that. I know what it's like to work with people who I don't like, but we're there to do a job, and we keep going. Trust me, I know. I think it's great when you see a production that generally enjoy each other's presence and love doing what they do and love being with each other all day. We saw all of them. Lori was Facebook Living the whole thing. Data ran out from AT&T. After that, we did the big group sessions, the group photos of everybody, where there's like 23 groups. We'll spend 4 minutes at each step and repeat in four corners of the next room over. Group 9, and you know, we just made our cycle. Every 4 minutes, Bobby would ring that cowbell like clockwork. Move on to the next. Being in our industry, after Buzz TV, being in media, we are very fortunate to have opportunities to meet with stars of shows that most people don't get or ever will get in their lives. We are very rare at this. We have to constantly remind ourselves that we are truly blessed. We get it every day. Every other day. It's a thing where we can easily forget and take for granted. I don't want to speak for James, but I think I can safely speak for both of us. Because we do this so much in the industry and we talk to so many people from so many different television shows, we forget the fact that other people don't get this chance. Other people won't get more than 30 seconds with these people, with the cast and crew members and directors and everyone who's part of their favorite shows or television movies. So we were very cognizant of that when it came to the group photo. Because during that, you can take your quick photo. Everyone's supposed to get in group, take a group photo, and then the rest, you can take that time to actually say hi, hug the cast members, and actually talk to these people. But you gotta remember, this is spread out through like 15 to 20 people per group, all in 4 minutes. Oh, don't mind me, guys. I'm literally simultaneously rendering our interviews that we did today. Oh, you can hear a little bit of that. So I'm literally now exporting my interview with Erin and Daniel. Get ready for it. It's going to be a while, you guys. Unfortunately, I'm on a laptop. But it's going to probably take an hour to render this. But okay, it's going. You're going to hear this, like, get all hot again. My computer is literally on fire. Just the heat, temperature wise, it's like burning my hands. If you haven't been following, I'm tired. Yeah, there it goes. So, oh yes, so people, we got our group photos. After that, James and I, we got our box lunch. We hid out in the green room. We just like went straight there, didn't want to risk anything. We didn't know how long the rest of the groups were going to take. So we made our way over to the green room and we just chilled, went over our questions, and we just waited for the cast to come into the green room. Eventually they all started coming along. Mark Humphreys was one of the first people into the green room. He was early, totally fine. We opened the door for him. He walked in and he gave me the biggest hug. He's an amazing hugger, you guys. He's an amazing hugger, Hearties. Like, amazing. I was hugging him. I'm like, oh my goodness. Okay, we're still hugging. Great hugger. He was cool. And he was like, I know you guys. I've watched you on TV. I'm like, he watches our after show. Who knew? Cool guy. Oh, I should have gone back a little bit. Sorry, guys. My mind is shot. Even before Mark Vancouver. We saw Erin at her corner for the group photo. And she saw us, of course. But, you know, she was tugged and pulled and everything. Totally fine. Respected that. And then it wasn't until, like, literally at the end when the bell was, like, ring. We finally just like went up to her and we're like, hi Erin. She knew us. She's like, James Lott Jr. Marissa. Gave us hugs, you know. And we're like, we'll talk later, don't worry. We won't waste your time. And she's like, yeah, go away you guys. You're wasting time. You're taking up everybody else's time. It's fine. Totally in a joking manner. But at least we said hi to her in our group photo. And I was like, we'll talk later. I mean, we get a sit down interview with her. Back to the green room. I'm trying to remember because, like, it's kind of a blur now, only because everything was just super exciting and now we're just kind of caught up in the moment. So if I don't go chronologically, that could be my brain going crazy and just lost in pure excitement of what was today. Set up the camera, set up our setting of where we're going to interview the cast members. We had two chairs in a corner. Just push them together a little bit. Got the framing, checked the sound on the camera. Had it set. We waited for a good while. Waited until they finally came in. Slowly but surely, the first person was Paul Green. Paul Green, who plays Carson, a new character in season 4 of When Plays the Heart. We didn't know anything about his character other than the fact that at the Q&A panel, he said his character lost his wife. And that's really all we know. I let James do it. I'm like, no, have fun. I get Aaron and Daniel. I'm not complaining whatsoever. So he was first, Paul Green. And then we get Pascal. Gorgeous. She is stunning. I'm rendering you guys. I'm literally rendering these interviews, and I'm like trying to make sure everything is not failing. This project already crashed on me once. Yes, I had to start over. Even though I saved the project, apparently I didn't save. So I had to start over. I lost like 20 minutes of work. It's unfortunate, but at least I knew what I was... I mean, like, I already know what I was doing. But that's 20 minutes of work. It's already... It's 10:45. I gotta get up early in the morning. So this is the second time I'm like rendering stuff. Pascal. She's gorgeous. She's stunning. She's funny! She is funny! She's witty! Beginning of the interview, we had Kevin just came into frame. Give her a kiss on the cheek. And I think he was leaving. He left early. We didn't get an interview with him, unfortunately. But they're so sweet. You know, those two, they work together. Again, showing like they genuinely like working with each other. I love Rosemary, and I love Pascal. Erin and Daniel are next. They slowly came into the green room. At AfterBuzz TV, we have a white room studio, and I'm constantly saying white room all the time. I think that's the color room that's ingrained in me instead of the green room. They came into the green room. And then, you know, they were taking a breather from just meeting 500 Hearties, taking all those photos, smiling more than 25 times within an hour and a half. God bless them. It had to be a lot, so it's like we weren't rushing them whatsoever. Production was running behind schedule. Totally fine. Totally understandable. I work in production. I know what it's like. It was like, they'll come to us when they're ready. And when we're here, we have our camera set up. It's on their time. Erin and Daniel actually went to another interview first. There was another media outlet there who got interviews with them. I think they did a group interview. Waited for them to finish. Then they slowly made their way across the room to us. Erin, she's gorgeous. She's a beautiful person, inside and out. Beautiful. Beautiful. Oh my god, she's amazing. And she's always been supportive of James, Maria, and myself. And AfterBuzz TV. She's been super supportive of AfterBuzz TV and our after show, When Plays the Heart. She's tweeted us out. She's actually watched our show. She's been on our show. She knows who we are. I heard her, like, when she was, like, trying to make her way over to us. She's like, I gotta talk to these fine people. I'm actually here to talk to these fine people. She eventually came over. But then Daniel just, like, kind of, like, walked by to our corner first. He somehow made it to us first. We were actually playing, like, individual interviews. Like, the way that it was set up, like, Daniel was now available. Erin was still talking to someone, you know, slowly making her way across the room. So I was like, I was going to interview Daniel first. I was like, all right, let's start. And then I think it was about like 20 seconds later, Erin saw that we already started. And she kind of, I don't want to say crashed, but she like got into the interview. I'm like, all right, you got to readjust. You situate the seating arrangement because it was only a one chair deal. I was in one chair, Daniel was in the other. Erin got into the interview. And we went from there. I purposely didn't ask any questions about engagement because I can't tell you how many times you're probably gonna get that question. Now, in the future, this season, I'm not gonna be that person. I'm not gonna ask the obvious. Everyone wants to know the obvious. It's not gonna happen yet, you guys. It's not gonna happen yet, Hearties. It was great. such a fun interview. Those two, I never met Daniel. I saw him at Home and Family back in April of 2016. So I saw him. Unfortunately, he wasn't feeling well. He left early, and I never officially met him until today. Shook his hand first, sat down, got situated, started the interview. During the interview, I kind of cornered him a little bit. I'm like, Erin's been in the studio. We need you to be in the studio. No, we need you to be on the app chat. And even Erin was like, it's so fun. So he's like, yeah, I will. And he got it on camera. You got it on camera, Hearties. He said he was going to come in. And then, wrap the interview. I'm literally rendering my interview with those two as we speak. You hear the RAM drive going crazy? That's because of me rendering Erin and Daniel's video right now. Finished the interview. I was like, you know, we're located in Los Angeles, our studios. He's like, okay, what episode do you want? 1, 2? I'm like, whatever episode. He's like, whatever episode is... I don't even exactly remember because it happens fast. And I'm like, yeah. He's like, just let me know whenever, and I'll be there. And he, like, looked me straight in the eye, so, like, I believed him. I was like, yes. Even after the interview, he confirmed that he was coming in. So, I'm going to hold him, and I'm going to believe he's true to his word, and he's going to come into the studio for our season 4 of When Calls the Heart. That's done. That's, like, that was, like, one of the biggest things that I wanted to get out of this whole event, to get confirmation that we can get Daniel on the show. Lori came. Lori! She's gorgeous. I love her too. Super sweet. Never met her either. Never seen her ever in real life up until today. Up until I met her. James interviewed her. James had a lot of questions that he like really wanted to ask her. I got Erin and Dan. I got the two lead stars of the show. I'm good. So long as Lee, I meet Lori. It was great. It was a great solid 10-minute interview. Good questions. Lori laughed a lot. There were like good, genuine moments where she had like a hearty laugh. And then, of course, I got a photo with her. Unfortunately, I didn't get a photo with Daniel. But if he comes to the studio, I can get my photo then. It's good. Got a photo with Erin. She's gorgeous. We got our interviews. It was fantastic. They eventually all left. Probably stayed around for like another 20 minutes. And then they eventually left. I'm so happy we got them. I'm so happy because, you know, production was running behind. Or, like, just the schedule was running behind. And I was just worried. I've been in too many productions to know, like, when things just get cut. There's, like, no time for it, or you're going to have to skip it. I'm starting to think the worst of like we may not even get these interviews. But we did. Thanks to Bobby. Bobby Schutte. You're amazing. We love you. I love you. And just the whole Hearty team. Even Brian. Brian, of course, was an integral part in these interviews. They helped set this up. They helped us get time with the actors, sit down, have a nice made conversation for more content to put out into the world for the Hearties to enjoy. For that, I'll be forever grateful. After they left, the stars from the group B started slowly coming into the green room. First saw Florence, the actress who plays Florence. I opened the door for her. Then Molly came in, opened the door for her. I was like, Flomo, Team Flomo, what's up? Didn't really talk to them. They were like kind of on a mission. I don't know. They seemed like they were, not I don't want to say distracted, but like they seemed like they had stuff to do. I'm not bothered them. Saw the April. She's adorable. Oh my gosh, she's so stinking cute. So stinking cute. Saw Carter. Carter was in the green room, met him. He's awesome. He's cute too. Carter, he even tweeted at James and I 2 days ago that he wanted to meet us. He tweeted at us individually saying he wanted to meet us. And we met him. I met his parents. His parents are super nice. Talked to his parents a little bit. Super nice. Of course, got a photo. And then, of course, we talked to Erin. Erin Buckles, who plays Jesse. And as you know, if you guys listen to my after show, I wasn't the biggest fan of Jesse. I was not his cheerleader. But I talked to Erin. James and I talked to Erin for like a good solid 20 minutes. Just one-on-one talking to him. The nicest guy. And he's tall. He's taller than James. The nicest guy. I'm like, alright. I may not like your character, but I like you. Oh my goodness, he was super nice. And there's nothing else to say. He was just like, he was so cool. I'm not sure if he was on the group panel because we talked to him for a long time. And everyone else already, like, left the green room. We saw some of the kids. The kids that came in and out. We had Opal. We had Brownie was there. And Andrea K. Brooks. I said hi to her. And, like, we hugged. She follows me on Twitter. I follow her. She knows about our show. I think she watches us. I kind of got her in passing. But, like, I did say hi to her. And, oh, yeah. Eva Warren was there. She was there. She's pretty. Super pretty. She was busy talking to everyone else. I was like, I'll meet her. If, you know, if it happens, I'll meet her. After that, James and I got back into the line for the whole group. The second round of group photos. During that, met up with Bobby and the Hearties team at the table that they were mingling. Kind of took over for the cowbell ringing every 4 minutes for Bobby. She was busy. I was like, I'll do it. I'll ring a bell. Can't be that hard. It was fun. It felt powerful, you know? It's empowering with the cowbell. Did that for probably like 10-15 minutes, every 4 minutes. Ring that bell. And need award style. Yeah, and eventually got to the end and I stopped ringing. And everyone was like heading back into the big conference room where everyone was kind of waiting. During that, James and I talked to Daryl from Hallmark and Crown Media. Talked to him for like a good 20 minutes and he's gonna help us so many ways back with us TV. Oh, just you wait. We're gonna have a good working relationship with him. Nice guy. During, the group photo, the second round of group photos, I was like talking to people, if you need my help for anything, I'm here. I'd like to help in any way that I can. And then of course took me up on my offer. And then tomorrow morning, which means I have to go to bed soon. Tomorrow morning, I have to go to the hotel early because I'm going to help assist with the bus tours in the morning. Going over to the When Calls the Heart actual set in Langley. Job is just making sure everyone gets on the bus. On the correct bus, I guess. Everyone gets on the bus. On time. In an efficient manner. So we can head over to Langley and check out the actual set. The practical sets. Go to Hope Valley. It's gonna be awesome. I'm tired. And I can't believe I'm still talking. I don't know who's ever listening to this. Like my brain's like, it's a great day. Oh my goodness, I'm like natural high. And then it was all over by like 6:30. And James and I left at like 6:30. Everyone else was like already crafting me gone. And then came back to the hotel, recouped rent, and got food, got dinner. So I didn't really eat today. I skipped my boxed lunch. I got one, but I ate the cookie first, other than the sandwich. I think I was just like kind of nervous for the interviews. I was like, I just wanted to make sure everything was gonna go smoothly, so I didn't really think about eating because that wasn't a priority. If that sounds terrible. Like, I just wanted to make sure everything was set up properly. If I didn't want to take the chance, like, I'm eating a sandwich and, like, walk in and I'm like, oh, no, give me a second, I didn't want that to happen. So I just, like, naturally wasn't hungry for the sandwich. But I saw a cookie. The cookie was phenomenal. I ate the cookie before the sandwich. Still currently rendering because if I wasn't doing this, this would probably might be going faster. Ooh. My airline is done. And Daniel's video is done. No, it's not. Sorry. I lied. 49 minutes left to time my Erin and Daniel. I have two more interviews to do. And it is currently 11:05. I have two more interviews to vendor. It was a great day. Day 3 in Vancouver. Technically day 2 of the event, but day 3 in Vancouver. Still can't believe I'm here. And especially after everything that happened today. Oh my god, I'm so excited for season 4 and what we have in store for all the Hearties. All the things that we're going to go through, it's going to be fun. My voice going, it feels like it's going. I'm tired. I'm going to sign off, render these last videos, and upload them. Don't worry, I'll post day 3 of Vancouver, Hearties Family Reunion. It's been amazing.